Hello everyone and welcome to Let's Play LEGO Indiana Jones The Original Adventures. That was quite loud, which is why I was waiting until now to say that. See, the rest of the game is really quiet in comparison to the title screen, so I had to balance it around the gameplay and not the very, very loud title screen. Now, of course, I'm playing DS version of this game because that's what I played as a child and therefore it is better than what you played as a child. No, I'm joking, obviously. You can like what you like, it's just I'm doing this one. This is a LEGO adaptation of the first three Indiana Jones movies. And we have this incredible DS video, which I swear looks better on an actual DS screen. Swear, okay? It looks better on a real DS screen. Now we are in the first level. Little tutorial thing. Press the X button to swap to a character. And then we're going to take in the pastime you've no doubt all taken part in LEGO games, destroying everything for money. And health, but there's no enemies here, so we don't actually want the health. Now, I have tried this once before, so I know each level takes about an hour. So, in other words, we are going to be doing a Let's Play of this for about as long as the Hexen one, when I did three, when I did like three parts each, or not three parts each, three playthroughs of the game. It's going to be about that long, except it's going to be one playthrough. Yep, characters carrying shovels can dig. I'm aware of that game. Also, I am emulating this, so I won't be using my thumb at all. And even if I weren't, I used a stylus like a civilized person. Of course, can't get up there. I assume... Actually, I know that's for another character if you come back in free play, because LEGO games are awesome. Seriously. Very good games. Especially the early ones. I don't know about the later ones. Also, yeah, you don't have to use the touchscreen for that one. You can just press the A button, which is what I did. Approach piles of Lego and hold the A button to build. That's good enough, right? Okay, fine. I'll build the whole thing. So, continuing to destroy. When the whip appears on the touchscreen, slide your thumb from the handle to the tip. Now, of course, like I said, I'm not gonna do that. And again, you can use the A button for that. Apparently, you don't have to use the touchscreen for very much in this game, despite what it tells you. And two characters are standing on them, so... This is the first thing that we have to use the touchscreen on. I legitimately don't think that the button will work on this. Yep, it doesn't. So, there we go. It's pretty hard to use a mouse to do this, but hey, what can you do? DS capture cards are expensive and very invasive. And I mean, like, invasive for the DS, so... You know, there isn't much I can do. Use your thumb to interact with the touchscreen. No. And yeah, I know you don't have to press A to build like that, but I do it sometimes. It's kind of fun. So now we have more money. We already have 15,000 studs. Which, if you know anything about LEGO games, you know that isn't very much. Despite what it appears to be. Objects with handles can often be pulled. Only often? Now, we're gonna line up here. Oh no! Enemies! And he died. Press the Y button to fight your enemies, which I have. And there are a bunch of collectibles in this game. Discover all three hidden map pieces to receive a LEGO artifact piece, which... I haven't played enough LEGO Star Wars recently enough to know what the equivalents to these would be, but probably minikits, if I had to guess. And this is my first LP recorded with a new microphone because my old one literally fell apart. I'm serious, part of it just fell off, so... Yeah. I have this now. There's enemies over there. Oh no, that was close enough to activate them. That's not good. I'm gonna beat you to death. And beat you to death too. Now we're gonna pull these. Ah, blowgun. Small characters can't pick up weapons. We don't have any small characters yet though, so it's okay. Down here. It marks where it wants you to jump down. Let's just leave that. Because we have something more important to build. A LEGO artifact. So that's what the minifigure equivalent is, because it says 10. And I know there are like 10 minifigures and such. So, we have the three maps to find another, and I'm pretty sure you can't get all of them on your first playthrough. It encourages replayability. Now, I have a key that sometimes works, sometimes doesn't, depending on the game, and thankfully it works for this one. Because blowing into the mic is the only option to put those out, and if... Because it's very finicky, a lot of games, unless you're using the original DS microphone, Mario Kart DS being a really good example. Thankfully, that one, you can use... excuse me, getting distracted. Thankfully, with that one, you can use the select button. For battle mode, which is the only point where it comes up. In this game, there is no other option, so very happy that it works. And... there we go. Now open the way forward. No. Enemies. Beating them to death. And he's just standing there. Thanks for the help, man. You types of inflatable rafts to cross water. Now, if I spend a lot of time destroying stuff, sorry, it's just how LEGO games are. They want you to do this. And I want to do it too, so I will. I will destroy. Here. We can't really do anything here aside from collect the money. Yes, yes, text. I am aware of how to use a boat. Of course, you wouldn't know that because this is a new file, but. Okay. See, only scholars can use this access panel. Now, apparently. We don't have a scholar with us, because, you know, characters can only have one type, and Indiana Jones is the Indiana Jones type, and this loser is irrelevant. I don't even know his name, so very irrelevant. See, only characters that have pet monkeys. Now, neither of us do. As you can tell, that is why I said this game is all about replayability. Finally, you're starting to actually fight things. Took him like half the level, but he's actually fighting. Need to interact with that. And here we have the blue blocks. And we need to put three of them on the blue Lego pad. And it's got a really, really impressive sound effect for a Lego video game. I'm not saying LEGO video games can't have super impressive sounds like that, it's just a bit weird. Okay, yeah, nothing else to destroy. Thank you. not gonna do that section yet. Because first I'm gonna get that torch and do whatever it told me to do. Even if I don't have to. Oh yeah, it's very impressive. Despite what it says, you can use buttons for a lot in this game, so it's fine. And would you look at that? Platform! Now, I really don't need this, I suppose. So I'll put it on the floor. Then switch to you, so that you can dig up whatever this is. Only thuggy characters. Well, I don't even think thuggy characters are in this movie. You know, the first movie, which this part is based on. I think they are in the next one. And we've nullified the trap. And I was an idiot and forgot to jump on the thing to get that first. To not break the game and do things you're not supposed to do. And I don't mean like, oh, game-breaking glitch because Torch came through room with you. No, I just mean like, you know, breaking a sequence in a puzzle because the developers didn't account, oh, you still have that Torch. We need to find a way to make you get rid of it. I didn't mean to do that, but, artifacts. Yeah! 3 out of 10. Now, that begs the question. Is there anything in there? Okay, just some money. Just some money. I'm gonna put that over there. Just so it doesn't bother me. I'll tell you what, I had a lot of trouble with these traps as a kid, so I didn't have this much money going into here. But, of course, I'm much better at video games now. So, there we go. There was a blue money somewhere, according to that camera. Oh, whatever. Oh, no. He's going to die. Now, if you don't mind, I'm just gonna smash every single one of these I see because it. Yay! Adventurer in the story mode. I'm not sure if True Adventurer is just like an overall thing, or if it's something you can get, you know, on a bi-level basis, but I probably won't do it anyway because it requires getting everything. But hey, we got Adventurer mode. I have missed so much of this. I'm surprised. I am no longer surprised. I am definitely no longer surprised. That is so me. As is that. I do it perfectly the first time, but now I just can't do it anymore. What a surprise. That is exactly like me. Oh! that's where the camera angle was for some reason. Because, yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, get up here, loser. Travel chutes to access new areas. Only small characters can do that. And obviously we aren't small, so therefore, come on. Destroy the thing. Okay, that's not destructible. Oh no. It's all red. That's... we just built a decoration to destroy it. Okay. What's in here? Because apparently we need it. I see. Stand on the fan and blow into the microphone to blow your character into the air. Well, if you don't mind. I'll just... microphone key. Get all the money. Because there is a lot more money in this area. I've got to be careful to try and avoid the money landing on the trap, because I can't walk on that at all. Even now that I'm over here, it's still active, so there is nothing I can do. Hop up. Oh yeah, there we go. There's the cutscene. No, you don't get to do that. I do. Now, I had a lot of trouble with this section as a child, so let's see if I'm still awful at it. Well, it looks like the answer's yes, but... I think he just spawned in another pit and died, like, a billion times. I almost feel bad for the guy. And I got the little red brick. I don't know what that does. You want the gem? Rubber ducky? Fine, I'll give you the stupid fucking head. Seriously, these cutscenes look better on a DS screen. Okay? I know it looks absolutely awful, but it is good on a DS screen. Yay, level complete! Free play unlocked. Temple of Doom and Last Crusade. I've also unlocked two characters for free play mode. Okay, his name is Satipo. That is a whopping 87,000 stars, 3 artifacts, a golden brick, 2 golden bricks, and a red power brick unlocked. Now, we finished that level, but I don't know how long the next one's gonna be, and my videos are usually this long, so I'm gonna call it here, and go on to the next level. I will see you guys next time for more LEGO Indiana Jones, the original adventures.